Congratulations, Imanuel. I'm happy you're getting married, and many, many well wishes.
Congratulations, E-Man. Man, happy for you. I'm happy to know you for, 2 years now? So, hopefully we still see you.
Congratulations, Manny and Lillian. Oh, I wish you all the best. Can't wait.
Congratulations, Manny and Lillian. Remember to keep Christ first in your life as your foundation. If you always need anything, we're down in Florida for you. Both love you, and you guys are going to have a wonderful life ahead of you.
Congratulations, Manny and Lillian. Today's your wedding. We wish as a couple all the best on your marriage, Lillian and
Okay. Hi, Lillian and Manny. We both are so excited about your relationship together. Congratulations, and we're happy to be here. We've seen you from a little girl, and now you're a grown woman, and you're getting married. Congratulations, we love you.
Hey, Manny. I'm really happy that you're getting married. You're growing up for sure. You're a cool guy. We met just a few years ago, and you've been awesome, and Lily's such a wonderful girl. And I really wish you guys the best marriage. Stay strong, stay together, and do many more.
Congratulations, sweetheart. You know we love you both, and yes, we wish you all the best.
Yes.
And continue to work at this because it is work. Love you both.
Yes. Compromise and share.
Congratulations, you guys. Wish you nothing but joy and happiness in your future and marriage. Love you guys.
Congratulations, soon to be young family.
Congratulations, couple, and congratulations, nephew.
Always keep God first, always communicate with each other, and I'm so happy for you guys. Love y'all.
Congratulations, man. You're blessed to be here. Best wishes to you and your wife, future wife.
Congratulations, Iman and Lillian. Wishing you years of success in your marriage and lots of happiness.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, E-Man and Lillian. E-Man, welcome to the next 50 to 60 years of your life, give or take a decade. You have time to figure it out.
Congratulations. Wish you both the best.
I feel fantastic. I feel good. I got my boys here, you know what I'm saying? You know, I got my fellas. You know what I mean? What's up, little man? Elijah.
And yours?
Manny.
Manny.
Manny. Oh, Manuel.
Timothy.
Andrew.
Chris.
Keith.
Vincent, father of the groom.
Congratulations, Imanuel and Lily. We're so happy for you. We're so happy for you.
Josh was happy too.
We wish you all the love and all the joy and all the peace that marriage can bring, marriage does bring. Just keep in your heart that God is love first. Put God first and then everything else.
And always, by the best, by the grace of God, keep the trouble that you know. I pray that your relationship is just as strong as ours, if not stronger.
Amen.
God bless you, man.
God bless you.
God bless you, Lily. We love you.
Yeah, it's great. So excited for today.
Yes.
You too. So excited for this day and for the beginning of your journey together.
Congratulations, we're so excited for you and so glad to be here.
Hi, Manny and Lily. I'm so excited for you guys and so happy for your future. I hope it's a blessed one and that you guys get to be a light to the world about what a true marriage will look like. Love y'all.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Love you guys.
All right, thank you.
Nervous, but I'm really excited to see my friend, you know, tie the knot.
Oh, congratulations, Lillian. I'm so happy for you.
Hey, girl.
Hey, Manny.
Congratulations, y'all. Today's the day, and yeah, we're all happy to be here.
Hey, guys. Congratulations on the big day. I'm so excited for you guys.
Congratulations. Aww. This is the best day.
Aww.
Congratulations.
Wait,
Congratulations, Lillian and Manny, and welcome to the family, Lillian.
Congratulations, Manny and Lillian.
Good luck.
Remember,
many, many happy days, and we love you both, and make the best of it. We are now one, husband and wife. Supposed to cleave onto each other. Okay? All right?
And remember, communication.
Communication, no hidden agendas.
Congratulations, Manny and Lillian. Wish you the best.
I want to congratulate the couple who are getting married. They're very nice friends of ours. And congratulate God bless.
Oh, congratulations, Manny and Lillian. Yes.
Congratulations.
Congratulations,
y'all.
Congratulations to the couple that's going to get married. That is my grandson. And she will be my... Now, what will she be to me?
Your granddaughter.
My granddaughter.
In-law.
In-law. And I hope you happiness and a well marriage. Stick with your husband. Stick with your wife.
Amen.
And God bless you.
Imanuel, God bless you all. From your tío Angelo.
Yes. Okay. Yes. I'm Lillian's father, and I wish them the absolute best, all the happiness in the world. May God bless them and continue to bless them all the days of their life.
Hello, hello, hello. Goodness grief. I remember when you were just starting out everything. Hi, love. This is Dr. Angel. Congratulations, and I'm glad that God gave you the woman that's for you, and I pray that it continues to shine brightly throughout your life, because you are worthy and she is worthy, and I pray to God that you too can recognize the gift in each other and appreciate the love that has you have been blessed with, and especially your wonderful mother and father.
And all my questions about my life.
Thank you. giveth this woman to this man to be married?
I do, my precious daughter.
You may be seated. Thank you all for being here on this joyous occasion and witnessing the love that the Lord has brought together this day. Before we go into the ceremony, Imanuel and Lillian will have words of expression of their love one for the other.
Dear Lily, ever since our first date, when you were so nervous about opening the hot sauce lid at Rico's Tacos, your hand was shaking to the second when I held it in mine, and God allowed me to see through time. I finally could see what God had in mind. I saw our future at that moment, the little ones in the back asleep, as we returned from a family retreat. From then on, I knew I wanted to take this journey with you. Lily, I want you to know what you've been to me and what I vowed to be to you. You have not only been my best friend, but you've been my confidant, my cheerleader, my prayer warrior, and my biggest God-fearing supporter. You understand the purpose God has for us and his people. When I'm going through, you've always said, "Don't worry, baby, God will see us through." Many days we prayed together, laughed together, and loved together. What I admire most about you is your humble yet strong heart. To me, you're the strongest, most courageous person I know. I know despite the trial and the test, you've shown me you never give up and you give it your best. You inspire me to have a heart as loving, compassionate, and humble as yours. Lily, baby, I vow to encourage and love you. Even when it's hard, I will be right here. Oh, we celebrate or something? Ain't nothing wrong with that. We in church. I vow to encourage and love you even when it's hard. I will be right there by your side saying, "Baby, we've got this." I promise to grow with you both physically, mentally, and spiritually. As Genesis 2:22 says, "Then the rib which the Lord God had taken from man, he made into a woman, and he brought her to the man. And Adam said, 'This is now bone of my bone.'"
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. "And flesh of my flesh, she shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore a man shall leave his mother and father and shall be joined to his wife, and they shall be made one flesh. As Adam did, I stand here today before my rib, the woman God has for me. And today I will be made one with you, as it was always meant to be. I love you. Te amo. Yo mi amor."
Husband, man, woman. The past year, 4 months and 4 weeks, have been a part of the most positive moments of my life. On April 14, 2022, I wrote down 3 journal entries and 1 day to ask for you. Each one as a written prayer between me and the Lord. The first one thanked Abba Father for what I had in my life that was going well. Family, a home, and the ability to eat quality food. The second entry was a request for my future husband to enter my life. Attributes were written of what I need in my husband, such as a man of God, a good communicator, family-oriented, and helps me become a better person. I'll define who you are. The third and last entry consisted of qualities I want in my future spouse, and what needs to change in my final relationship prior to marriage, all of which proudly defines who you are. 3 days later, on April 17, 2002, or known as Resurrection Sunday, We matched on Facebook dating. 3 days later, we had our first date. On our second date, I learned of our similar values, such as health and being of the same Christian denomination. I knew you were meant for me and initiated our first kiss. Lake Minnipook Chungji will always be our sweet and special spot forever. I know our marriage will be... Turning to the next page. Blessed by the Lord, because while getting closer to our wedding day, we saw threes and sevens everywhere, from our car dashboards to our fitness watches. Three is a symbol of the loving trinity of the Lord, three in one. In addition, the husband and wife are united with God as the head. I promise to submit to you, as Ephesians 5:22 commands women to do so. Society tells women that submission to their husbands is weak, but Jesus submitted to God himself.
Amen.
For they are one and the same in power, and the same in one. In the same way, a woman is not below a man, and a man is not above a woman. Men and women have specific roles designed for the good of humanity. I will always strive to be patient and try my best. Wherever life leads us, I promise to be by your side and support you. To you, I promise that our holy matrimony and love is forever. I love you very much, mi amor. This is only our beginning.
Those wonderful expressions of their love, and it just confirms that we're here on the right day at the right time for these two beautiful people. And as we begin our ceremony, dearly beloved, we are gathered here together, here in the sight of God and in the face of this company, to join this man, Imanuel Vincent Young, and this woman, Lillian Linnea Braga Flores, in holy matrimony, which is commended of by the Apostle Paul to be honorable among all men, and therefore is not by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. And to this holy estate, these two persons present come now to be joined. If anyone can show just cause, while they may not lawfully be joined together, let them now speak, or else hereafter forever hold their peace. Amen. By your silence, I presume there is no cause. Lillian and Imanuel, I require and charge you both, as you will answer at the day of judgment, when the secrets of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know of any impediment why ye may not be lawfully joined together in holy matrimony, ye do now confess it. For be well assured that if any persons are joined together otherwise than as God's word allows, their marriage is not spiritually lawful. Amen. Thank God, no impediments. No causes. Emmanuel, repeat after me. Emmanuel, wilt thou have Lillian to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinances in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her so long as ye both shall live. Amen. Lillian, wilt thou have Emmanuel to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinances in the holy estate of matrimony. Wilt thou love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and in forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him, so long as you both shall live. Imanuel, repeat after me. I, Imanuel, take thee, Lillian.
I, Imanuel, take thee, Lillian.
To my wedded wife.
To my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinances.
According to God's holy ordinances.
Lillian, repeat after me. I, Lillian, take thee, Emmanuel.
I, Lillian, take thee, Emmanuel.
To my wedded husband.
To my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinances.
According to God's holy ordinances.
May we have the reins. Manual taker. As a pledge, repeat after me, as a pledge and in token,
as a pledge and in token,
of the vows between us made,
of the vows between us made,
with this ring I be wed,
with this ring I be wed,
in the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
of the Son,
and of the Holy Ghost,
of the Holy Ghost,
amen.
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 This time Lillian and Imanuel, when you take your candles, like the center candle representing unity in your marriage, unity with the Lord. Those whom God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. For as much as Imanuel and Lillian have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and thereto have given and pledged their troth, each to the other, and have declared the same by joining hands and giving and receiving a ring, I pronounce that they are man and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. At this time, may you please bow and we have a word of prayer. Most holy and all-wise God, Lord, we thank you for these two beautiful people, Lord. We thank you for sanctioning their union, Lord. We ask that you would continue to be in their marriage, be the center of their marriage, Lord. Bless their going out and their coming in, Lord. Bless their seed as you tarry, Lord. Bless their every effort to please you, Lord. Continue to grow their love, Lord, that they might not separate one from another, but be truly bound, hallelujah, in the precious name of Jesus, Lord. We ask these things in the name of the Father, the blessed Son, and the precious Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Nothing else to say. It's time to do. You may kiss your bride.
Go ahead, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's with great joy I like to present to you for the very first time Mr. Imanuel, yes. Vincent and Mrs. Lillian Lanier Flores Young.
All right.
Congratulations. Yeah.
What's up,
congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
I think it was great. I'm so happy for them. I don't know what to do.
Oh, that's a good picture. Hey, what's up, Mr. Anderson? What's up, Mr. Anderson? You know what I'm saying?
I love you.
Hey, what's up, Mr. Anderson?
I love you.
Nice to meet you, man. Hey, it's good to see you.
Just like so treat her right.
Absolutely.
I'm so happy.
Uh-oh.
Watch out for the jar. Oh my god! How are you? You look so beautiful! Oh,
that really matches your skin, like the dress and this.
No, this.
No, he's joking. James is joking.
No, no.
It's a long time coming, and you know, we are very happy that, you know, this is happening for him. We think that Lillian is going to be a good wife, and we know he man going to be a good husband, so, you know, just don't want him to call me for the next 2 weeks.
Congratulations, Lillian and Imanuel, you know.
Exactly.
You can definitely count on us if you guys need anything.
And you can't say you don't cry, because we heard you crying.
Saw your lips?
Oh, man, so happy for you guys, man. Blessings, much love.
We did great. We did great.
Yeah, support all the way, man. Happy for you.
Congratulations.
Oh, they did a wonderful job.
It was great.
Yes, they look so beautiful. And I had tears. I hope I didn't press my makeup.
I almost cried.
Son Imanuel
and our new daughter.
Our new daughter. I'm not going to say daughter-in-law. Daughter. Amen.
Amen.
Lillian, we just wish them all the best. And our prayers are constantly with them. And we just, it was a lovely day. And we look for many more. Happy
New Year.
Oh. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Oh, congratulations.
That's the same time.
Congratulations.
You just throw that. Hey, that's
I didn't think about that.
Got you.
Thank you, brother. Y'all doing an excellent job.
Hey, we are on top. Put this together. I'm going to capture it. He's gonna open a door there. Thank you.
But we're not ready yet. Who's Jacob? So did you call him to announce the play the music?
Yeah, you want
to. The thing is, I need the maids and the rooms to be moved into the air.
Good afternoon. I have the pleasure of announcing the beloved couple's bridal party. So we ask that when they walk in, you just greet them with a hand clap and a hooray. And we would like to introduce first bridesmaid and groomsmen Brittany Rodriguez Luna and Andrew Young. Next we have Miss Yvonne Sehu and Christopher Young. Miss Arita Goodwin and Timothy Young. Miss Cheyenne Young and Mr. Manny-san Deshell. Honor and best man, we have Miss Emily Braga Flora, and we have Mr. Isaiah Coleman.
Now introducing Mrs. and Mr. Emmanuel Young.
Thank you so much for coming.
are very thankful for this day, for Lillian and Imanuel. The blessing of the food, despite the intake that we've already had, we still want to honor Almighty God. At this time, we'll pray in prayer. Gracious Father, we thank you for the day. We thank you for your loving kindness and your tender mercy. We thank you for this wedding party. We thank you for the lovely couple. Now, Father, we are asking a blessing over the food that we're intaking. We thank you for its preparation and the hands that have prepared it. We ask that you bless it as we continue to receive it. In Jesus' name and for his sake we pray. Amen.
Amen.
It's your day, man.
It's our day.
Yes.
Yes, pray together. You guys pray together all the time. And do not go to bed mad at each other. Always make sure you work everything out.
Keep it fun and exciting and never get bored with one another. Don't become too familiar that they just become like the scenery. But cherish every new moment because every day is new.
Excellent. All right. Mine is the 10-minute rule. So if something your partner does bothers you, wait 10 minutes. If you're still thinking about it, you got to talk about it. If you forget about it, it wasn't that big of a deal. 10-minute rule.
Come on, you own.
Here you go. Try to be open-minded and compromise with each other. And just try to keep communication open. That's the key. Love it.
What he said?
Ditto, huh?
He took.
I don't care what the rest of these ladies are talking about, but the husband is always right. Remember that, E-Man.
What you got to say?
I'm going to say exactly what Kai said. Just keep open communication and everything will be all right.
Thanks.
Yep.
Thank you.
I'm nodding.
I mentor him.
Okay.
So he got all my wisdom. Okay. Wisdom.
He's hearing you now.
Oh. Hey, Emmanuel, Mr. Wilson, I've already given it to you. You know what to do with it. Bless you.
Thank you.
Man, what I would suggest is two things. Accountability and character. You only have one character, you'll be on spot.
Wisdom for the newlyweds. Well, an old timer would say that the best way to save a marriage is learn to communicate. Learn to communicate, learn to share, learn to be patient with each other, and learn to be patient with yourself. Because when someone points something out to you that you need to correct, you need to think about it, and you need to be patient, acting on that, so that you can improve yourself, and thereby help your relationship with the other, and help yourself. So, that's my words of wisdom, learn to communicate and learn to share.
Thank you so much. And I guess you agree with that?
I wrote down on the online invitation, I put already my advice, but yes, the first and second and third advice is communication skills.
Thank you.
Learn how to negotiate and be happy.
Thank you.
But I'm going to say it in Spanish, okay? Dios bendiga, Lilia y esposo, les deseo lo mejor del mundo, los amo en el amor del Señor, que Dios les bendiga, que Dios les fortalezca y siempre con amor resolviendo cualquier situación, que Dios los guarde y Dios los bendiga.
I'll go to you first.
Congrats again. Any wisdom for the newlyweds? Always be patient with each other. Always talk it out. And, you know, be budgeting when the baby shower comes.
Yes, I'm going to echo what this beautiful lady said. Communicate with each other. Understand your boundaries. Work with each other. You're a team. You're not against each other.
Communicate and love each other. That's really about it.
There you go.
Your battles. There's some things that just aren't worth pursuing. There's some things you're just better off letting her win. So pick your battles, pick them well, and you will sleep better at night.
Sometimes you just gotta nod your head and disagree. Just nod your head, or just smile and wave like you usually do.
I'm good for now. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
We gotta get back from him. We gotta get back from him. Maybe we went back here. I got it. What's up? How are you, man?
Should have already received your glasses to toast, and we will have speeches from the mother and father of the bride, mother and father of the groom, and we'll round it out with speeches and toasts from our maid of honor and best man. In that order, please. Let us welcome Mr. and Mrs. Flores.
I prepared a long speech, but I'm not going to read it. I'm going to give you the short version.
Which is good.
And then, because some of our family members are from Brazil, and they speak Portuguese, so we were just going to do, I'll read the each paragraph, and then Mavia, my sister-in-law, my wife's sister, she'll translate it. So as they record this, the folks in Brazil can see it too. Okay. All right, so, beloved guests, family and friends, thank you very much for honoring us today to celebrate Lillian and Manny's holy matrimony. Genesis 2:24, therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. Genesis 2:24.
Amados convidados, familiares e amigos, muito obrigada por nos honrar hoje para celebrar o sagrado matrimônio de Lilia e Manny. Gênesis 2:24. Portanto, deixará o homem, pai e mãe, e se unirá à sua esposa, e serão uma só carne.
So if you're wondering why my wife didn't read that in Portuguese, well, that she didn't bring her reading glasses because, you know, she has to stay as beautiful as possible, right? But I tell her she looks lovely to me with or without glasses.
That's right. That's right.
Lillian and Manny, now Mr. and Mrs. Young, may God, our Heavenly Father, bless you and keep you all the days of your lives. May you always walk with God, Matthew 6:33. But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all of these things will be given to you as well, Matthew 6:33.
Lilia e Manny, agora, Senhor e Senhora Young, que Deus nosso Pai Celestial os abençoe e os guarde todos os dias de suas vidas. Que você caminhe sempre com Deus, Mateus 6:33. Mas buscai primeiro o reino e a sua justiça, e todas essas coisas vos serão dadas também.
Okay. Do not fear, Jesus said in John 14:27. Peace I leave you with you. My peace I give you, not as the world gives, do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. John 14:27.
Não temas, Jesus disse em João 14:27. Deixo-vos a paz, a minha paz vos dou, não como o mundo dá, eu dou a você. Não se perturbe o seu coração, nem tenha medo. João 14:27.
Marriage is a lifelong commitment to each other. Therefore, let your love blossom and grow. Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. Philippians 4:13.
O casamento é compromisso vitalício, com o outro. Portanto, deixe seu amor florescer e crescer. Filipenses 4:13. Posso todas as coisas naquele que me fortalece.
Last dance. Never forget that we love you. May our Heavenly Father grant you peace, love, and prosperous lives together.
Amen. Nunca se esqueça que te amamos muito. Que nosso Pai Celestial lhes conceda paz, amor, e vida próspera juntos. Em nome de Jesus.
In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Amen.
Em nome de Jesus, amém.
Amen. God bless you all. We want to thank you for being here to support Lillian, amen, and Manuel. We thank God for your presence. It's obviously love that brought each of you here. When my son was born, amen, there was a spirit on him, a spirit of love. And the Bible teaches us to train up a child in the way that he should go, and when they should go, and when they're older, they will not depart. And I thank God for him, even as my father had an impression on me and my mother. Amen. We hope and pray my wife and I have had an impression on you as well, son. Lillian, we love you. And we welcome you to our family. This morning, I want you to know she called me Pop. Amen. I said I have 3 daughters now. And I want you to know, Mr. Flores, my wife is beautiful as well. As well as your wife. And she looks lovely. Doesn't she look lovely? Amen. I want to thank my family for supporting us as well and helping us grow our son into the man that he is today. We love you all. Now my wife is scratching my back, so she wants me to leave her some time.
Yes, 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 yes. Thank you all. God bless you, Lillian and Manny, all the days of your life. We love you. She called me Momsy, and I call her daughter. And I love all of you, all my children. I thank all our family for coming out and supporting us. And because when you support Manny and Lillian, you support us. And God bless you.
And I just want to say we pray the blessing of our Heavenly Father be upon your marriage, and that the Spirit of the Lord direct your path, and that he could lead you and guide you into all truth. And if you follow his path, that God's blessing will always be upon you. Amen. It will follow you like your shadow follow you. So always leave space in your marriage for God. Amen. God bless you.
To come out today to help celebrate Imanuel and Lillian's marriage. I must apologize firsthand because I personally am not feeling well at the moment, so I had to cut my speech short, but it's still filled with a lot of emotion just the same. So please bear with me. Also, if I shake, it's okay, I'm just nervous. To Lillian, I wrote this speech in the morning of the wedding, thinking of what I could talk about today. As siblings, I feel like I should finally celebrate getting our childhood bedroom all to myself.
That's right.
Or that I'll never have to wait to use the bathroom again. And yet, it's a bittersweet feeling. You are entering a new chapter of life where I cannot follow you, but I can support you from the sidelines. I love you very much, Lillian, and I wish you the best. To Manny, please treat Lillian well with compassion, kindness, and above all, love. May God please guide you and Lillian with wisdom and strength in your new futures together. I hope you cherish her just as me and my family have cherished her throughout these years. It doesn't take much to know how much you love her and how much you care for her. Welcome to the family as well. At this time, if everyone could please raise your glass and toast to our newlyweds. To the newlyweds. Thank you for your time.
About 14 years.
What?
Yeah. So He may have came a long way in his journey in life to become a man. I mean, oodles and noodles with orange juice. Like in the oodles and noodles. To now eating whole shrimp. And I just mean the whole entire shrimp. You know. Yeah, exactly. So he has come a very long way. And especially with his faith in God, you have a very blessed life. And Lillian has a very strong blessing on her.
Yes,
and I want y'all to grow and confine each other together. I can't follow Mr. Neil's speech with a scripture, but I'm going to say my scripture anyway. Okay. So my scripture from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Love, that's not the right one. I'm sorry. I was about to tell y'all the wrong one. I don't want to do that. Well, I'm going to do it anyway. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself and is not buffed up. Does not behave rudely and does not seek its own. It is not provoked, nor does it think evil. Does not rejoice in injury, but rejoices in truth. Bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. For y'all who don't know, that's a letter from Paul to the church of Corinth. And what it is he is telling the Christians, this is what love is. So to help correct their behavior back then. So, Iman, Lillian, truly, you're on my heart. Okay, I will always be there for anything you need. You can always call me. I know you're going to Hawaii. If y'all didn't know, they're going to Hawaii on Wednesday. Between tonight and next week, don't call me about your little sex page. I work hard. Everybody else, please raise your glass. And let's toast to Emmanuel and Lillian Young. Oh, thank you. Apparently I got my glass too. To the Youngs, thank you.
Hey.
Awesome job. Woo!
Make sure I'm not too loud. Okay, that sounds great. So I want to thank everyone for coming to celebrate me and Manny's marital union. From the bottom of my heart, I would like to thank my parents for making the reception possible, and Manny's parents for decorating and making it decorating the church and making it beautiful with every decoration filled with love. Thank you to my Aunt Fatima, Mavia, and Uncle Robert for traveling all the way from Florida to support me and Manny. Thank you to my friend Yvonne for joining us from Texas. In addition, thank you Rachel and Ariel for joining us from Pennsylvania. I would like to say a very special and loving thank you to Manny's family. Any of your family joining from Trinidad today?
I don't think they could have made it, but they sent us gifts.
Okay. thank you. If they joined on Zoom, thank you so much for supporting us. And to my parents, I want to thank you for blessing my marriage. It is a bittersweet feeling, coincidentally, like Emily said. That's what I wrote down in my book. Getting married. I will miss living under the same roof as you both, and we need to accept it's my time. True, genuine love is letting me go and trusting I will always make my way back to you. Manny and I promise to visit as much as we can, and I promise to pay the priceless gift of love you both have given me forward when the time is right and I have my own children. Thank you to everyone for coming. Manny and I are both so honored and thankful for all the love that you have shared with us. May the Lord bless you all. And this is not in the speech, but I just want to say thank you, Emily, for being the best maid of honor I could ask for.
Aw, look at that.
I don't know what I was expecting, but you have surpassed all of my expectations regarding what I expected you to do. Thank you for going above and beyond your duties, and I hope to surpass my expectations with whatever it is happens when you get married. Any way that I can support you, I will be there for you every step of the way. I am here for you forever. Just because I am moving does not mean that I have abandoned you. You can call me whenever you want. You can text me. I am here for you. And I love you so much. It made me so happy today to see you walk down the aisle and see how elegant and beautiful you appeared and happy. Always remember, you are beautiful, you are worth it, and you are enough. Thank you everyone for coming. Manny and I are so thankful and honored for the love you have shared with us. May the Lord bless you all, and may this event be one of many celebrations we have uniting both our sides of the family for moments of joy.
Amen. I want to thank everyone for coming out. I want to first and foremost thank my parents for what they have done, and Lillian's parents for all that you've done for both of us. And I want to give a special shout out to my grandmother. 95, she'll be 95 in December. You look elegant, Grandma. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your love. I just feel so overwhelmed with love and appreciation from everybody who's here. Hallelujah. I want to thank, I have so many people to thank. I want to give on to Lillian's family, Uncle Robert, and it's her aunts and everybody who came up from Florida who gave a beautiful speech. You know, give them a round of applause. I want to thank my best man for that speech. You know what I mean? I don't remember no OJ and noodles, but I think it may have been Sunny D. Don't quote me on that. But I just want to thank all my friends who came out, my family who came out, everybody who is here in this place today. You know, the photographers, the videographers, I mean, they are consummate professionals. The caterers, thank you so much. The decorators, my Uncle Keith for officiating a beautiful ceremony. And, you know, and I gotta give we have to give a special shout out to Sister Namneet, you know, for her prayers, for her gift of prophecy. Hallelujah. When she first met Lillian and I, she said, this is the right door. And you know, and I thank God for her love, her undying support, you know, and God God has a special calling on you, hallelujah, God. And I thank you for using that calling in a powerful way to bless us. And you bless us every time, you know. And so I thank you. We thank you. Hallelujah. And I just want to say that, you know, and I want to give a special shout out to my sisters. My sisters, Shine and Jasmine. For them to come out and to support us. And I, you know, I, just as Lily said about her sister Emily, and you're my sister now too. You're my sister now. And for my sisters to show up and decorate and get these, get this place nice and beautiful. And so my older sister, who is the IT manager, you know what I'm saying, of the event, it means the world to me. It means words I cannot express. So I thank you.
Yes, sir.
I thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Yes, sir. Love you, Manny.
I love you too. You know, I probably, I'm, you know, there's some dust in here. You know? I don't know, they changed the filter. but I love my wife. I'm thankful that God gave her to me. I believe that with all my heart, soul, and spirit. And I know that God has blessed me, but not only blessed me, He's blessed me with each and every one of you. For your presence, your love, and my mentor, Mr. Wilson, back there. I give him a round of applause, and him and his wife, they've been married 46 years, praise God. I couldn't do it like Mr. Wilson on his wedding day. He had the bell bottoms looking real smooth, you know what I'm saying? Looking good. But I love you and your wife, Mr. Wilson. Thank you all for, you know, what you've done. Your presence has blessed us so much. And to Lily's friends over here, thank you. Thank you so much for coming out. We love you all. If you're her friend, you're my friend. If you're her family, you're my family. And vice versa. Thank you to my CSM crew, my family over there. That's my family, y'all. That came back 2009. You know what I'm saying? Little 18-year-old me came to CSM. I said, where's the CC building? Is it Smash Bros? Oh, it was a good time. But I appreciate all to my new friend Chris over there. Thank you so much, brother, for showing up. And you know, I love you all. Hallelujah. Lily and I love you all. We're going to we dedicate our marriage to not only us, but we dedicate it to the Lord. Hallelujah. We made a pact that we will grow not only naturally, spiritually, but we will grow in Christ. And our marriage, hallelujah, is not just for this world. Hallelujah. Our marriage is to bring more people into the kingdom of Christ, to get more people to give His name to praise. My father-in-law, I can say that now. I used to always say future father-in-law. You know, to hear you, to read the scriptures in such a beautiful way, God is pleased. And you have blessed us greatly with your love, and to her and Lily's mom, to love to my parents, and your love, thank you for supporting us. Thank you for everything. I don't know what I can say in words. And of course, my godparents over there. I can't forget my aunts and uncles over there, too, now. You know what I'm saying? They look good, boy, I tell you. You know, and to my church family, to my aunts and uncles, continuing again, to David, to Danielle, to Tim, to, oh my goodness, to Andrew, Timothy, Chris, everybody. You know what I mean? Manny's son. All of Lily's bridal showers. I know I'm going on. I'm just so happy. I can't, you know. But I want everybody here to know how much I appreciate you. And we love you. And may God bless you as He blesses us. Hallelujah, God. And Isaiah, I can assure you, you won't be hearing from me, Clay. Maybe when we get back, I don't know. But I love you all, and God bless. And we raise our glass. Thank you.
Before we continue, I just want to say something short yet impactful, and please forgive me for leaving this out. This is, to be honest, me and Manny, we thought about these speeches a few days before the wedding. There's been so much going on. However, I would like to sincerely thank my Uncle Angelo for coming all the way from Delaware. It means so much that you came this way to support me. There's a reason why I'm keeping Flores in my middle name, and that's because I have a lot of admiration for our family and the sacrifices that they made from living in an apartment in New York City and living in a small house with 8 children. The fact that you guys overcame what you went through and worked hard for what you have means so much to me. And to see my father's side of the family and my mother's go through so much and just never give up, it inspires me every day to move forward. So it's a part that I will carry with me for the rest of my life as my middle name, and I am proud to carry it as still a part of me and my identity. And I also want to thank, I also want to say a special appreciation towards Cheyenne and Jasmine. I know that in time our relationship as sisters will grow, and I hope to continue to improve my relationship with you guys, because the love that I have for my sister, the love that I shared with her, is the same love I have for you both. And I am excited to grow it more and more every single day with you both. I am here for you both. Whatever you need, don't be afraid to call or text me, even if it is just to say hi or tell me anything. I'm here for you, and I am excited to be your new sister. And thank you for all my bridesmaids, the groomsmen. Thank you everyone for coming. We are so thankful for everyone that's here, both my side and Manny's side. And baby, you can continue with your speech.
Oh, all right. Oh, okay. All right. You gotta change the dust filters, y'all. But we love y'all. We'll raise a toast. May God bless each and every one of us, our families. May He bless our future, but not only our future, but the future of the church and the future of God's people. And we'll go ahead and toast.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
Yes.
nicely done.
Thank you. we didn't want to go a little too crazy.
No.
I was thinking about getting an ice cream. I appreciate it. Thank you.
We are going to get ready to prepare for cake, but while we're preparing for cake, we need all the single ladies to come forward at this time for the bridal toss and the bouquet toss. So all the single ladies, come forward at this time. Three, two, one, go!
makes you want to think about it. Good job. Good job. Hey. Can we take a photo for you?
Don't do it.
I mean, you got a hug like
yours
now.
Oh, where's
her man? I know he's back
in. There you go, that's it.
Smile, smile.
Cake is good.
This is your cake.
Really good.
Oh, delicious, beautiful.
Red velvet and
cream cheese,
yeah. What's not to like, huh?
Oh, what's not to like? You right about that, sir. What's not to like? We cheers to that.
Great.
Yeah, I always love family and that.
I had so much fun. Thank you so much for inviting us. It was a great time. You guys have fun. Congratulations again.
This is good. I keep feeling this thing. It's like it's not feeling this thing.
Y'all marriage. I can see it already. That's it.
Because we don't live in your house.
You will be living in my house.
I don't know if I'm wise enough for that.
Well, if you have anything you'd like to say, go for it.
It was a beautiful day, guys. So grateful to be here to share it with you. And wish you just all the best in your relationship. You're an absolutely beautiful couple. And just all the best.
Thank you.
I got nothing.
What she said.
Stay friends, because that's like the built foundation. Wish nothing but the absolute best for you guys.
I just want to say congratulations, and I hope y'all have a nice, long marriage, and you know, keep God in your prayers, and just make sure you guys work with each other and make sure everything lasts and work hard.
We're already blessed.
That's right.
What are you talking about?
I know, right? We already living in the blessed.
More than blessed. I mean.
Oh yes, sir. Praise the Lord. That's definitely appreciate you.
You too.
Jeremy, nice to meet you, brother. Hey, how you doing?
So they're like our font, but we swapped it. That's what we were just talking
about. Thank you. Hold on,
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I want to wish you a very happy marriage. And God bless you with many blessings. And may God keep you just blessings of all your life and your heart.
Amen.
Beautiful bride.
I receive that. Thank you, brother.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. It's two people. Three people.
Yes, ma'am.
Husband, wife, and Jesus.
Amen. That's it.
Amen.
You got it right. Hey, that's powerful. Hey.
I know what you're doing.
As long as you guys do it right, like, yeah, just go to bed angry if you have to. Go to bed separately if you have to. But keep running the race. Keep God.
That's all right. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, look at that. That's okay. That's okay.
Yeah,
girl, keep going. The fact that you said that—that's your—that's the deep desire of your heart. And I know that one day you will have someone in your life, a man or a woman that's good for you, that will give you exactly what you just told me. You just told me exactly what you need. He is out there, whether it's Sage, whether it's someone else, you will figure it out in your own time. And he has not forsaken you. I said my vows and my reception speech for a reason. That's a testimony. And I wrote down in my journal what I needed to be. Hold on to faith, because I thought he did, and I really did. There was a period of time I had anger towards God, because I thought he just didn't care about me. And then, somehow, I met my husband. You will find the man that's meant for you in the right time. Sometimes you may think that, oh, I'm ready, but you may only just be a seed. And that could be nothing against you. It could just be something you're just not aware of yet, or something that needs to grow inside of you, or maybe something that needs to grow in your future.
Right.
Once that seed grows in the right time, that's when.
How's it feel? Your first meal together.
It feels
really
good.
Excited for our future together.
Yeah, me too. I'm very excited. Good to see everybody. Thanks for coming out. Beautiful.
Thank you so much for coming.